Welcome back, guys. Will Robinson here from Robinson's Auto. Getting ready to take this 2002 Kia Sedona for a test drive. They have a noise coming from the front end. Let's go see what's going on. Did you guys order this? The road's a little wet. You see how when I turn to one side to the other, it gets better? Turn to the driver's side, it gets worse. Almost goes away when I turn to the passenger side.
Yeah.
Now that the vehicle up on the lift, I could hear that rumbling. Hopefully you could hear it. It's weird, it transfers through it, but you could tell that the noise is further away. So with that, I'm gonna make the call. Left front wheel bearing. All right, Christmas came early. I got the Astro 1823, 625 foot-pounds of torque. It's the Nano. All right, let's see what she does. Also been reading and hearing some good reviews about this Astro 40SL Max. It's 450 lumens. And anything I can do to improve the quality for you guys is might as well get the best of the best, you know? And I'm sure you've seen this one used in many other videos. Next, we're gonna come in here. We're gonna remove this cotter pin, pop this tie rod, because this spindle is gonna have to be removed from the car completely in order to press out this wheel bearing. I notified the customer, they're on a budget. Even though this boot is torn on the tie rod, there isn't any significant play in it. It should be replaced. But yeah, look at that, not too bad. Thought I had a pair of cotton pliers. All right, with that cotter pin removed, now we can take and zip the nut off. We'll be using a little brother Nano from Astro. This is an 1828 3/8 drive. The last one was a half inch. Should be a 17, however, I'm using 11/16 because I forgot to pick up the metric set, but it fits it good. Beautiful. We want to avoid any damage to this boot, even though it's already torn and whatnot. But if this does have a good boot on it, a lot of times you'll damage it with a pickle fork. So what I found over the years, I mean, if you want to protect the threads, you can start the nut back on it just in case you slip. However, we won't be hitting that. What you're just gonna do is hit the knuckle. Just like that. Just put that there for safekeeping. Now I just want to knock the tie rod out first because now I can move everything around without unlocking the steering wheel. You could do this in many different steps, but I'm gonna take and zip off this axle nut. I believe that's a 32. All right, let's see if this Nano has enough oomph. Oh yeah, struggled a little bit, but she went. Oh, and it's gonna be free, that's good. All right, instead of removing the caliper from the bracket has to be removed on one. We also know that it needs front pads. Rotors appear to be pretty decent. So this will be coming in for a follow-up service after this wheel bearing is replaced. But today's focus is strictly on this front wheel bearing. So we have a, it's a Cornwall 21 millimeter swivel. Man, this thing is impressive, guys. I am truly impressed. See the rust flying that was in there for some time. Next we got, you know, our hangers that we made a long time ago at a brake line. Put these however you gotta put them. You just don't want that caliper hanging from the hose. All right, let's take this rotor off. What I use for these normally, if they don't come loose right away, these ones are in there pretty good, is an impact screwdriver. Thank you. Now for the lower ball joint. As you can see, it's a pinch style. With ease. You can tell I don't have to spread it or anything because the ball joint isn't spinning with the spindle anymore. So we could take and we could separate that. Or better yet, I'm gonna leave it sitting in there. All right, so next we're gonna take and remove these two retaining bolts from the strut to the spindle. You could take and mark this, however, there's no movement, so the alignment isn't gonna be affected from this procedure. I'm just gonna throw a second light up there because what a difference that makes. Let's see what she has to her. Notice I really didn't even need to put a wrench on that side because it wasn't spinning. So what I do is I'll take a 3/4 and I'll get this spinning inside itself. Kind of clean itself up. That way I don't have to beat it out. Let's see it. Pry bar, please. It's almost there. There it goes. And pull her out. You can see how hot this has gotten in the grease. And I didn't soak anything up on the as far as the actual shaft goes. So the grease is coming out of the bearing. And I hope you could hear that over the camera. But yeah, got some flat spots. Okay, so now we're gonna have to take and press everything apart. So you have your spindle and then you have your hub. You can see right here where the hub comes through the inner race of the wheel bearing. These are split wheel bearings. There's actually two of them in there. So we're gonna have to push the hub out first because there's a C-clip, or a retaining clip, I should say, behind here that's gonna retain the bearing from pushing out. So we just gotta set this up. If you have some kind of claw pusher, like a puller, you could probably get away with that. But since I have the press, I'm gonna utilize it. Okay, so I got the new wheel bearing here, just arrived. And as you can see, it is a sealed bearing. I had to find a socket that went through the inner race. So we know this is the correct size socket and it's gonna push through. Now it's probably not the best thing to use sockets. You could probably get a kit that has all different size pushers on it. However, all my kits do not have this size. I could use, oh, look at that. That pusher I made for doing that dual clutch transmission on that Ford. However, I don't want to damage that. So we are going to use this. At some point, this hub is going to drop and it's going to hit the floor if we don't have a way of catching it. And it may damage a couple of your lugs. So we want to prevent that from happening. Try to be a little proactive. But as crazy as this may look, I take a 5-gallon bucket, or pail, whatever you want to call it, and I kind of place it underneath there like so. That way once it pops, it'll fall down into the bucket. It's in the bucket. But as you can see it happen, the one inner race stayed in, unfortunately. However, we can now get to the snap ring, and you can see they are a tapered style roller bearing. I mean, it's not a complete taper, but it's two separate bearings. So I'll show you how to press that apart in a little bit. Next, we're gonna take and remove this retaining ring. So I need your set of snap ring pliers. I usually use like a punch of some sort. You'll see there's these two flats, one on each side, and then you have the two holes down here. Those are for the pliers. And I usually like to break these loose because they can get rusted in there. So looks like I'm spinning. There, now I just watched the whole clip actually spin inside. So now I know it's kind of free. Nothing's free, but we know it's loose. Not loose, but able to be squeezed. All right, so now I grabbed a screwdriver. The screwdriver has to be a Mac, because like I mentioned before, the snap on the tip will just break right off. Just playing, guys. But I'll get it going like that, and then I'll just walk it off the rest of the way. It's a pretty robust tip, but it gets rusted in there. Now we can take and press the bearing, the outer race, out. I could use that same socket that we used earlier, because I could push on that center race, because this is the old bearing. So it's these bearings on the opposing side, they're not going to push through. I can almost guarantee that, but it will push the outer race out. With this down press, I'm going to have to block it up slightly. I want to get this one centered, because that might have been some of my problem last time. I wasn't pressing center, and it might have twisted a little bit, and I kept that inner race on, but I doubt it, because it doesn't look like it even started moving off its seat. Hopefully you can see that there. We have the inner race, and this is going to push against it. Now I'm going to just show you how to disassemble it with the press, but I might attempt to reassemble it on a bench with a kit for doing just that. And bingo, was it bingo?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, there you go. Bingo. Okay, so as you see, I pulled through and we're out. Okay, so thankfully the local parts store has this seal. Now there's many ways that we could go about knocking that out, but I'm just gonna knock it out from the backside since we're here. I'm gonna take and I'm gonna clean this down and prepare it. Essentially, you get away with maybe a piece of emery cloth. Just clean this outer lip off where we have some rust buildup. Maybe scrape out that ring with a pick, and then I'll get it right back to you. Okay, and just like that, we're back, all cleaned up, ready for the new bearing. Now for the reassembly, we can do this simply on the press by taking this bearing, pressing against this outer race and pressing it down in, getting something with the same outside diameter. You do not want to press it in by the inner race, because you'll be pushing against the bearings at that point and putting a preload on them that you really shouldn't be doing. Sometimes use the old bearing, because as you've seen, before it gets to that snap ring, it's got a few thousandths. It'll slip in and out. So you'll be able to get that old bearing back out once you press this one in deep enough. However, what we're gonna do is I'm gonna show you how to install this bearing if you were to have a wheel bearing kit. The one I'll be using today is from Astro. It's 78825 is the part number. It doesn't cover Kia, unfortunately. However, we can make it work. You know, you just gotta think outside the box on occasion. So what you gotta do is pick one. It fits in nice. Like that one there feels pretty good. That one there is probably perfect. We'll just see what, if this one's too big. Yeah, so that one's too big. So in this kit, it's going to be number 5. So as you see, number 5 also fits, has a step here, and that also fits inside the inner race. So we will not be pushing on that inner race, because it's dished out in that spot. And you won't be causing any preload on that inner race and damaging that bearing. That's the whole trick of doing this. I'm gonna take and I'm gonna put this in the vise just to make it a little bit easier for me. Okay, and I also wanna make it clear that if it wasn't for the hub being inside that inner race of that baron, we could have used this kit to complete the whole job. So unless I'm missing something, please advise me otherwise. But I had to use my press to get the hub out, so I simply used a press to press it the rest of the way apart. But once I had that hub out, I could have simply removed this retainer ring, grabbed this kit, and separated everything, put it back together. Everything from here on forward, I could do with this kit. And like I mentioned earlier, if I had some kind of puller, I could have easily clamped it from this backside and drove it out as well. Next, I'm gonna simply just pick another adapter that will press against this outer portion and not pull through, of course. And that one actually feels perfect. If you look in here, there's actually a step. And what I found is the number 4 adapter fits that step perfect. So what that will do is actually help center this for me. So it seems like I'm gonna be using 4 and 5. 4 on the backside, 5 on the front. Now you could just simply go with any big one, push it against that backside, and drive her home, and that would probably work just fine as well. All right, then from the Astro kit, we're gonna get the bolt and place a washer on there like so. Got another washer for the opposing side and the nut. We will get our baron started. It comes with a small film of grease applied already. Now it's very important to try to get this started as square as possible. So we have that started in there. We're gonna take and place our bolt through here. And our bolt through here. Put our backside on. That's gonna help center it. One more washer, and then the nut. Make sure everything is squared up. And that's a beautiful situation right there, guys. Same 32 millimeter that we used on the axle nut, we're gonna also use to drive this in with the Nano, how this works out. Once you hear it get solid, then you know you're all the way. It's bottomed out. Okay, so as you can see, now that we pressed it in, everything still spins smooth as silk. That's because we put no pressure at all on that inner race. We only strictly pushed on that outer race. That's where the proper tools for the job come in handy. They dished this out for that reason, because sometimes this inner race can stick out just a little bit further than that outer race, and you'll put something flat on there that goes across both, and then you'll preload this inner race in a way that it really wasn't made to be preloaded, and it may not be perfect or whatnot, but you could damage these barons really easy. So I highly recommend this kit or one similar. This one seemed to work really well. Next, we're gonna take and put in our snap ring. Okay, I cleaned up the snap ring, and as you can see, the snap ring has a little bit of a dish to it, kind of like a concave and a convex, almost like a spoon, you know what I mean? So the concave side is gonna come out, the convex side would go in. There you go. In. Sometimes what I'll do is, once I get her to pop like so, as you can see, that's perfect. The inner barons are made to press together. Like when you torque down the axle with the nut, it's gonna torque these together and set your preload. So these are made to push together. So when we press that in, we're gonna be pressing from the backside against this inner race, and then against the front of the hub. So I'll cover that more as we go. So next we have the hub, and that inner race is still on there. We need to press that off. So there's this groove right in here. I'm gonna try to take my bearing splitter and grab it in that groove. I would try to grab it from underneath. However, sometimes you'll damage that ledge and have to clean it up later. So our first attempt will be grabbing it by this ledge and seeing if we could get it to start going, and then maybe moving the bearing splitter underneath. Sometimes you gotta take and you gotta split these, but we're gonna attempt it with the proper tools. I know it looks like it's upside down, but that's the way. I think I'm gonna wanna grab it. I installed it kinda upside down than what you would normally see, but we have it caught inside that groove. Press it apart, just like so. Now, this is a hardened race, so you wanna stand back. Should be a shield around this or whatnot, because if that were to break, it could shatter and then little pieces will fly. Most times finding you. I am not gonna stand near here. I'm gonna stand back and you guys let me know if she starts pushing. Actually, it looks like it started to move off its seat, doesn't it? She started to go. But what I have to be careful for, we have these wheel studs that are sticking out underneath, right? And I have this press. I don't want to damage those wheel studs. But I have a couple inches, and actually now I feel relatively safe standing here since she's off her seat. But if she flexes too much, no, we're good. All right, we're down to the studs, and I don't want to damage them, so I'm going to take this off now. I could have did this a little sooner, but now I can put it into the press like so. It's a little cold in the house today. Good enough. Abracadabra. Now that the hub is all prepped and ready to be pressed in, you gotta use some caution on this step. A lot of people would wanna just put this on here like so and just start pressing in without supporting the opposing side of the inner race on it, the inner race. Okay, so if you were to just press this in, you're gonna start pressing in, but then you're gonna start pressing against the back inner race and end up popping it apart like what happened on the old one. We weren't worried about the old one when we popped it apart, but it was a good demonstration to show you how this can simply pop out of the opposing side if you don't support it. So now, to put it together, we're gonna support the inner race from the opposing side, and then we'll push on the front side of this hub. So for this side, we just gotta find an adapter that's gonna push here, right? Actually, number 13 adapter of the Astro kit fits perfect for this side. All right, so 13 on this side. 11 will work, and there's a little bit bigger shoulder, so I don't mind using the washer on that side. So. Remember, pushing against the inner race. So you have an idea from both sides. want to get this started as square as possible. Let me see that little hammer right there too. So now that we have a little bit of pressure on there, that's looking pretty good. Right. And at no time should this bearing bind up. But she's going in. And you can tell it's going in pretty straight. Make sure, guys, that you put that snap ring in before you press this together. I've seen that done before, and I have done it myself before. So I think, since it's going in smooth, we're gonna grab the Nano. And we're gonna send her home. I run it in until it sounds solid. She's not moving. And even at this point, you should be able to feel it, and it should be smooth as silk. Alrighty. Sounds a lot better, right?
Yeah.
Feels good. Another handy thing that I just noticed is this number 3 adapter from the Astro Kit. It's gonna work perfect for pushing this seal in. As you can see, it's a lip seal and it has this outer piece on it, right? If we take and we push against that, it's gonna damage it, and trying to find a socket that fits that outer perimeter is gonna be very difficult. But with these dish style adapters, it'll go in just like so, and it fits perfect around the outer perimeter, and this lip has a place to go because of that dish. So we can put that in there like so, get it on there, and send her home. Set it up and actually pull the seal in. However, what I'm gonna do, let's get it started like so, where it looks good. Okay. Then I'm gonna use a dead blow. And that seems to have set that seal perfect. All right, now that we have everything clean and prepped, I'm just gonna take and put a little bit of grease around this perimeter for that seal. That's where that seal's gonna ride. Start getting the axle to slide through. That little sitter down onto the ball joint like so. Might as well get her ball joint bolt right away and get that in there. I'll take it. These little bolts. Tighten down the ball joint as well. Make sure this perimeter is cleaned. Same thing with the inside of the rotor. All that stuff can throw you off balance. I got some grease on here from my dirty mitts. Hopefully you guys can see everything that's going on. All right, now that everything's reassembled per se, we can take and put the tie rod on. At this point, I don't know if you guys really need to be swung around to see that. But essentially, I'm just gonna install this castle nut. I can do this one by hand. Now we just gotta line that. As you can see, there's the hole. We gotta get it to that next portion. Right there. Reinstall our cotter pin, push it in tight. Down, down. Ball joint pinch bolt, 69-85. I have my torque wrench set to 72. Okay. 88 to 102, I have mine set to 92. Halfway between like that, but. Okay. Okay, next we're gonna torque the axle nut. That gets torqued down to 177 to 199, so I believe I'm gonna go right around 185. A happy medium. Tammy's inside holding the brake for me. We may potentially be able to stick something in between the rotor, but this one has a really skinny inner portion there. So we're gonna just torque this to 185. You got it? Turn the wheel and hold it for me. Right there. We wanna do this in one motion. Try not to get too jerky with it. Right there. And then we're gonna stop. Okay, straighten up the wheel. Ah, that sounds good. It actually spins so much freer, right? Yeah. So we're all torqued to spec. We're ready to take it for a ride. Let's do it to it. Here's after. Take a listen to before. So like always, thanks for watching. If you liked, give me a thumbs up. If you haven't done so already, please subscribe and click that bell for more notifications. And I'm gonna try not to wreck this vehicle on my way back to the shop. Thanks for watching.